Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Let's slice data with Saurav. Today we are here to learn new thing that is called if else command in Python, which is very important. You know, when you start working in Python and start coding, this if else command will become a key to write any kind of code there. If else is nothing but it is asking for a condition. You know, as I told you, there are some logical operators, right, which is comparing two values. And if you say that if this particular value is true, then print this or do this. Otherwise, else do that. So let's focus on that. And I have opened this Google Colab notebook here. You can write it in the Jupyter as well. So anything is fine. So let's say we'll start here. If else command in Python. Okay, we will write a very simple program. Let's say A is equal to 4 and B is equal to 5. Simple. So whenever we are writing this if else command, we have to remember one thing, that if always, how to write this particular command. If open parentheses, and you have to write in inverted or you have to write in condition, what condition you want to give. So I want to give A is greater than B. So I'm saying if A is greater than B, then colon, if this condition satisfied, print A. Okay, if this condition satisfied, print A, else, and remember this thing, this is called the indentation. So if open bracket A is greater than B and this colon, then when you hit enter, it will not go in the beginning, it is going after this F particular thing. And do not, you know, people will erase this space and print it from the first row, from the first space, then it will give you an indentation error. So always remember this thing. And whenever you're writing anything in if else, you have to, you know, give this particular space. Automatically, it will come after, you know, colon. When you hit enter, it will go here only. And else will start, you know, below the if. So this is called indentation. You have to remember this thing. Else, I'm saying print B. Okay. Let's run this program and see what will happen. So it is printing 5 for me. Why? Because it is comparing the two values A and B. A is 4, B is 5. A is our variable which is storing the integer value 4 into it, and they are comparing A and B. They are saying that if A is greater than B, then print A, or else print B. So it is printing the B. So you can give anything. Let's say for giving anything, we have to write the input code here. So let us go to the new, you know, cell here. And I will say A is equal to integer, because I want the customer to integer input. And then in the open parentheses, you have to write enter your first number. And this, as I told you, that is a string, so it will print as it is. Then I will say b is equal to integer again, integer, open parentheses, and say input. And in open parentheses, you have to put inverted comma and say enter your second number. And then you have to say c is equal to, I did integer again, input from a customer. Enter your third number. So basically what I want to do, I want to compare these three numbers and I want to print the greatest number, or you can print the smallest number as well, whatever you want. So let's say I say how to start this program. See, if there are only two conditions, you have to give if else. If there are more than two, here we have three conditions, so you have to give if elif, E-L-I-F as the second condition. And the third condition will become the else. So see how we are writing that. If, and I'm saying A is greater than B and A is greater than C. Okay. So I'm taking the two conditions here, that whether A is greater than B and means both the conditions should be satisfied. Colon, enter, then print A. Okay. Enter. As I told you that if you have more than two conditions, you have to write elif, short form of else if, nested if commands, you can say that. then you have to say else if, and you have to compare. What you have to compare? B. If it is greater than A, and B is greater than C. If these two commands are, you know, satisfied, both the conditions are satisfied, then print B. Else, if you have to write else, again you have to go from the beginning and then indentation and then say print. It will automatically come. You don't have to write this indentation again and again. It will automatically come. You don't have to give any space here. It will come automatically. But when you're writing elif, else, so this will be in a, you know, sequence, like if starting from here, else if starting from here, and else is starting from here. Print command are after the indentation. If you don't do this, this will give you an error, indentation error. So let's run this program and see how it is working. So first thing, it is asking for the first number, I'm saying 12. Second number, I'm saying 14. And third number, I'm saying 15. So it will compare and print the biggest number for me. So it is printing 15. That is the biggest number. Okay, let's run it one more time. Let's say I give 12, enter. And then again, I will say 12. Okay, because I have given a dot there, that's why error and error. Again, run it. I want to give two numbers same. So 12, and the third number 15. Let's see what it is printing. So it is comparing. In this case, A and B both are equal, but it has to print the largest number because it has to satisfy all these conditions. If A is greater than B and greater than C, then only it will print A. If B is greater than A and B is greater than C, then only it will print B. Otherwise, it will print C because C is the greatest number. So this kind of small programs, you have to, you know, until unless you start practicing on that, you start writing in your notebook and you are not getting any error, that is great. But if you get any error, please go through Google, and there is a website called Stack Overflow. It will help you. Otherwise, you know, put your comments and I will definitely help you there. But if until unless you start typing them, you will not learn them for sure. Because Python is something which you have to go through. You have to type. You have to make mistakes. Then only you can learn. So hope you like this particular video. Please like, subscribe, and share my channel with the students and the guys who want to learn Python. Have a good day. Thank you very much. Bye.